Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. May we remind everybody to please switch off or silent mode our mobile phones now. Thank you. The Mass is being offered to the following intentions. For those celebrating their birthday, Lorna Libay Dapitan, Larlin Espinosa, Saldi Balboa, Gabriel Balboa, Frixian P. Gaspar, Cirilla Cabahog, Coel Chan, Jover Marfe, for those celebrating their Thanksgiving, Giselle May Molina, Corazon Raboy and family, Cis Anaceta Item and family, Capacin and Aspillaga family, Pentecostes and family, Ignacio Bayag and family, Efleda Agbayani Agbawa, Mr. Mo family, Alvarez family. For the anniversary of Mr. and Mrs. Saldi Balboa, and for the departed souls, especially the souls of Maria Victoria Ignacio Macapagal, Coralina Alberto Soriano, Graciano Rojas, Lalin Sumalakay Magno, Julia Magno, Jose and Mercedes Balenio, Adriano Salvation Magno, Federico and Alberto Magno, Rosemary Magno, Loretta Laguna Lorca, Eduardo Matapaha Seniors, Julia Gallego, Sebastian Mangibin, Leonarda Mangibin, Guillermo Mangibin, and Josephine Mangibin, Silva Barreto, Agostino Barreto, Alberto Solartin, Remedios Balboa, Dayan, Colinas Jacinto, Simon Herosa, Presentacion Herosa, Presentacion Laureno. The Mass we are about to celebrate today is the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. God in this holy place, God who unites those who dwell in his house, he himself gives might and strength to his people. Our Mass presider is Reverend Father Raja Dugumpidi Pimi. Please stand.
Begin this celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, coming together as one family to celebrate this Eucharist, let us pause for a moment, accept our unworthiness, our sinfulness, and ask the Lord for pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. O God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. You alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that, with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Let us all be seated and listen attentively to the Word of God. First reading, Elisha's servant knows the little offering will not be enough to feed 100 men. But through the prophet, the Lord multiplies the loaf for the hungry.
A reading from the second book of Kings. A man came from Baal Shalisha, bringing to Elisha, the man of God, 20 barley loaves made from the first fruits and fresh grain in the ear. Elisha said, "Give it to the people to eat." But his servant objected, "How can I set this before 100 people?" Elisha insisted, "Give it to the people to eat, for thus says the Lord, they shall eat and there shall be some left over." And when they had eaten, there was some left over, as the Lord had said. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
The eyes of all look hopefully to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
The Lord is just in all ways and holy in all works. The Lord is near to all who can call upon him and all who can call him in truth.
The hands of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. Second reading. Paul pleads for a life in keeping with the gospel. He stresses the need for unity and harmony.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one Spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your call. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all, and through all, and in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us all stand to honor the Holy Gospel.
From the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee. A large crowd followed him because they saw the signs he was performing on the sick. Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. The Jewish feast of Passover was near. When Jesus raised his eyes and saw that a large crowd was coming to him, he said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food for them to eat?" He said this to test him, because he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for each of them to have a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good are these for so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people recline." Now there was a great deal of grass in that place. So the men reclined, about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also as much of the fish as they wanted. When they had had their fill, he said to the disciples, "Gather the fragments left over so that nothing will be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves that had been more than they could eat. When the people saw the sign he had done, they said, "This is truly the prophet, the one who is to come in the world." Since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
How are you? Good to see you again. As I always say, that your Saturday group is very, very lucky. Because you have the aircon and you have enough space. You can choose also where to sit. No? While the Sunday group is large crowd, you know, they're all outside under the hot sun. So that's why I always say, you are very, very lucky. In today's gospel, we heard a miracle, multiplication of the 5 loaves and the 2 fish. This is the only miracle which is recorded in all the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and today we heard from John. So the multiplication of the 5 loaves and the 2 fish. This is recorded in all the 4 Gospels, and so it is a very, very important miracle. And let us see what this miracle can tell us to each one of us today. Because this took place more than 2,000 years ago near the Sea of Galilee. But we are reading the Gospel after more than 2,000 years. It is not 1 year or half a year or 5 years. So more than 2,000 years afterwards, we are still reading the Bible, we are still reading the Gospel, and we are still reading the miracles, the teachings of Jesus. Now, first thing is that the people like to listen to Jesus. That is why wherever Jesus was going, the people were following. And so, many people gathered around Jesus. They want to hear again and again and again. I heard that in the Philippines, no? If you like a party, no? You also follow the party. Wherever the party goes for mass, you also go there, right? Because you like him, huh? Maybe you have a crush, no? So, people, that's why, Bakit magsimba ano kasi guwapong pari, ha? That is why you go to different barrios wherever the party goes. Okay, now, people loved to listen to Jesus, no? And that is why they were coming from different places. This is very important. Each one of us should have the same desire, same thirst to hear Jesus again and again. That's why I tell people that everybody, we should have the habit of reading the Word of God every day. Because when we read the Word of God, when we hear the Word of God, we are listening to Jesus again and again. That means we also have the hunger, we also have the desire, the thirst to listen to Jesus again and again. Like the people, we also should cultivate this habit. I tell you, even if you find 2 or 3 minutes, it's very, very valuable. Your day will be blessed, and all the works that you do also will be blessed. Because you have the hunger, desire to listen to Jesus again and again. Now, the second thing is that many people have gathered, and they did not think about the food. And Jesus asked the Philip, and Philip also does not know what to do. And then Andrew finds a boy who has 5 loaves and 2 fish. Now, this boy is also very, very important figure in this miracle. So he was buying food, and maybe he wanted to bring home, but he also was there to listen to Jesus. Now, this boy is willing. That is also very important. They found a boy with 5 loaves and 2 fish, but then this boy is very important because he was willing to share the food with them. It is very little, and there was a multitude of crowd. And can you imagine, no? And it was impossible to think that everybody would get something to eat. But then this boy was willing to share the food with them. Now that is very important. And afterwards, the miracle takes place. Now, dear brothers and sisters, this is very important because many times we think that our contribution is very little. Many times we think like that. But then remember, your contribution, little or bigger, doesn't matter. But then your heart, your willingness to share what is possible for you with the others. what is possible for you with the others. And so this sharing, do not think only material things. No, even your prayers, even the love, if you are willing to share with others, there will be a miracle. Your love, your prayers, your friendship, your care, concern, forgiveness, everything. So do not think that only the material things. No, everything, if you are willing to share with others, there will be a miracle. Now this boy was willing to share, and there was a miracle. Now Jesus takes the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, and then he gives thanks, and then only they share the food. Remember, even if it is small thing that you do, if you are willing to share, remember that it will be blessed by the Lord. That is why we can see a miracle. If you are willing to forgive others, your action, your forgiveness will be blessed by the Lord. And there we can see a miracle. So, dear brothers and sisters, all our actions, all our prayers, all that we do, if we are willing to share, it will be surely blessed by the Lord. And remember that it will be blessed by the Lord, and it will be multiplied by the Lord. That is very important. And finally, the people have eaten a lot. The 5 loaves and the 2 fish multiplied by Jesus, everybody ate. They were full. And when they saw that Jesus was performing the miracle, they were so happy. They were so happy. And the gospel says, I recommend you to read again later. The gospel says they want to make him a king because he was performing the miracles. And they cannot imagine so many people were able to eat with small thing. And they saw that this one was performing miracles, so he's a great man, so let us make him a king. Let us make him a king. But then the gospel says he withdrew again to the mountain alone. So he did not want to become a king at that time. So Jesus was very, very cautious also. He does not become a king when you want to make him a king. Because the people want to make him a king because of the miracle. But Jesus becomes the king when he wants to become a king. When did he want to become a king? He became a king on the cross. On the cross, when he gave life, on the cross, he became a king. So the miracle, they want to make him a king, but he said no. He left alone, he went away. But then on the cross, he becomes a king because he was giving his life. He was giving the love. He was giving the forgiveness, everything. So there he becomes the king. So dear brothers and sisters, when you are willing to share the values with other people, your actions are blessed and you will become a king. You are blessed and you will be the part of the kingdom of God. You will become a disciple of Christ. This is very important. And so let us, in this Eucharist, continue to ask the Lord to give us a heart that is willing to share the values with other people. God bless you. I believe in one God.
The Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us pray to the Heavenly Father that we may, like Jesus, become bread that brings life to one another. Let us pray our response. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May Pope Francis, all bishops, the clergy, the religious, and all lay faithful truly become bread for both body and soul, especially for those who are hungry for the word, for God's love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May all civil leaders and public servants become aware that they are called to become and provide bread for the common goods. May they utilize their position to promote and preserve the dignity of every human being, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May all of us gathered today, both hungry and satisfied, be reminded of our mission to provide for and nourish one another materially and spiritually amidst the COVID-19 pandemic, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
May the faithful departed be fed the heavenly bread as they become eternally in communion with you, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us pray for our own personal intention. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Eternal Father, help us imitate Jesus, the bread of life, that we may faithfully participate in the building of your kingdom here on earth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation, through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty. and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of our faith.
Beneath this banner, this star, we prepare a door until
Amen. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, John Thong our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
With faith and confidence, let us address the Father in the words our Lord has taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to this banquet.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter,
but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. Prayer for deliverance from the pandemic. God, you are the source of all goodness. We come to you to invoke your mercy. You have created the universe with harmony and beauty. Yet through our pride, we have disrupted the course of nature and brought about an ecological crisis, which affects our health and the well-being of the human family. For this, we ask for your forgiveness. O God, look pity on our plight, for we are in the midst of a new viral pandemic. May we experience again your fatherly care, restore order and harmony to nature, and recreate a new mind and heart in us, that we may look after our earth life like a faithful steward. O God, we entrust to you all the sick and their families. May you bring healing to their body, mind, and spirit, enabling them to partake the Paschal mystery of your Son. Help all members of our society to pray the proper rules and strengthen the spirit of solidarity among them. Sustain our frontline medical and healthcare workers, social workers, and educators. Come especially to the aid of those in need of resources to safeguard their health. We believe that it's in you who direct the course of human history, and that your love can change our destiny for the better. Whatever might be our human condition, grant a steadfast faith to all Christians that even in the midst of tears and chaos, they may carry out the mission they have entrusted to them. O God, bless our human family abundantly, and dispel from us all evil. Deliver us from the pandemic that is afflicting us, so that we may praise and thank you with renewed hearts. For you are the author of life, and with your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in unity of the Holy Spirit, you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Prayer for the Holy Souls. Eternal Father, I offer you the most precious body and blood of your divine Son, Jesus. In union with the masses said throughout the world today, for all the holy souls in purgatory, for sinners everywhere, for sinners in the universal church, for those in my own home and in my family. Amen. Let us give thanks to Almighty God, Yahweh El Shaddai, for the victorious celebration and blessing we receive on this Holy Mass. Thank you, Father Raja, for being with us today. And in behalf of Saturday Group, El Shaddai, DWXI Prayer Partners International, everyone is invited to join the fellowship right after the Mass. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
And we will say,
Lord, let's go.
And we will say,